സാമ്പത്തിക പൊതുയോഗം ചേരുന്നത്. ചെയർമാൻ മുകേഷ് അംബാനി നിക്ഷേപകരെ
അഭിസംബോധന I welcome all of you to the 43rd annual general meeting of the company. This meeting is held through video conferencing and other audiovisual means because of the lockdown. This is in compliance with the circulars issued by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, the Government of India and the Securities and Exchange Board of India. The company has taken all feasible steps to ensure that the shareholders are provided an opportunity to participate in the annual general meeting and vote. Adequate video conferencing facility and live webcast of the proceedings of these meetings have been also provided. The requisite quorum is present, and therefore I call the meeting to order. The register of directors and key managerial personnel and their shareholding and register of contracts or arrangements in which directors are interested are available. These will remain accessible to the members for inspection electronically if they so desire. I wish to introduce, for the benefit of new members, my colleagues on the board of the company. Most respected Sri Y.P. Trivedi. Dr. Raghunath A. Mashelkar. Professor Deepak Jain. Sri Adil Zanulbhai. Sri R. S. Gujral. Dr. Sumit Banerjee, Srimati Arundhati Bhattacharya, Sri K. V. Chaudhary, Srimati Neeta Ambani, Sri Nikhil Meswani, Sri Hital Meswani, Sri PMS Prasad, Sri PK Kapil, Sri P.K. Kapil, all the directors of the company are present at this meeting. Sri Alok Agarwal and V. Srikanth, CFOs, Sri K. Sethuraman and Srimati Savitri Parekh, company secretaries, and the representatives of our statutory auditors and secretarial auditor are also present at this meeting. Ladies and gentlemen, the notice dated June 20th, 2020, convening this annual general meeting and a copy of the annual report for the financial year ended March 31, 2020, has already been circulated to members of the company electronically. With your permission, I shall take them as read. The auditor's report on the standalone and consolidated financial statements and the secretarial audit report of the company for the financial year ended March 31, 2020 do not contain any qualification, reservation, adverse remark or disclaimer. Accordingly, the reports are not required to be read out as provided in the Companies Act 2013. Now, with your permission, I will begin my formal address to the shareholders. My dear share owners, a very warm good afternoon to each and every one of you. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the 43rd Annual General Meeting of Reliance Industries Limited. Dear shareholders, the Corona crisis is the most disruptive event in modern human history. The resultant economic crisis has compounded the global community's hardships. However, I have no doubt that India and the world will achieve faster progress, greater prosperity, and a new quality of development post the COVID crisis. And I also strongly believe that every adversity presents multiple new opportunities. Take this AGM itself. All of us are participating in it through our brand new digital product called JioMeet. JioMeet, since its release a few days ago, has already been downloaded by more than 5 million users. It is India's first and only cloud-based video conferencing app. And you will be proud to know that it has been built by a young Jio Platforms team in just the past few months. Dear friends, the company's accounts for the year ended 31st March 2020 have already been circulated to you. With your permission, I would like to take them as read. Reliance has had yet another year of record performance. Reliance became the first Indian company to exceed market capitalization of $150 billion. Reliance is also the first Indian company to cross 100,000 crores in consolidated EBITDA. The earnings from our O2C and upstream businesses declined due to the challenging market environment. Yet, the consolidated performance was up 10% over the last year due to strong growth in organized retail and our digital services business. Our consumer businesses continued to deliver hyper-growth with an EBITDA growth of 49% this year. Consumer businesses today contribute to about 35% of our consolidated EBITDA. Just 5 years ago, nearly all of our EBITDA was from our energy, hydrocarbon and materials business. Since then, our consumer and technology businesses have rapidly achieved scale by their exponential growth. Dear shareholders, Reliance's seminal contribution to the Indian economy remains unmatched. Here are a few snapshots. At over 200,000 crores, we continue to be India's largest exporter, accounting for 9.1% of India's total merchandise exports across 109 countries. We are India's highest taxpayer of customs and excise duty in the private sector with payments of over 21,660 crores. We are amongst the highest payers of GST and VAT at over 69,372 crores. We are also the highest payers of income tax in the private sector, paying 8,386 crores last year. Dear share owners, in last year's AGM speech, I had shared my goals of growing our business through